time is now. Do you wanna give them all when the time is now? You've seen the rest, now you got the rest when the time is now.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Yesterday we had total darkness on the campus of Marion University, but today total sunshine as it is 65 or 71 and sunny here on the west side of Indianapolis. Mitch Huppert here calling the action between the Marion Knights and the Grace College Lancers. We've got a home Crossroads League softball doubleheader here for you today. Marion's first home games in 10 days. Marion last played at home on March 30th against Mount Vernon Nazarene. Today they are taking on the Lancers of Grace College. We're going to roll through lineups real quick and take a break once we get to our national anthem. The leadoff hitter for, we'll start with Grace's lineup. It'll be Bella Duran at second base, Hallie Nett at shortstop, Jerry Ellis, who will be our game two pitcher for the Lancers. She will be the designated player in game one, batting third. First baseman Cassie Hayes will bat fourth. Tia O'Connor will bat fifth, number 28. In the sixth hole is the center fielder today, number 21, Madison Ganey, batting seventh. And catching is Bree Gardiner. The pitcher and starting pitcher for Grace College in today's game one of the two is number 14, Chloe Huff. Huff will be making her 10th start of the season with carrying a 4.22 ERA, and we'll talk more on that later. Montana Brinks will bat in the nine hole in left field, and in the flex position for the Lancers is number 33, Ashlyn Irwin out of Churubusco High School. She's playing right field in that flex position. And your Marion lineup today, folks, as we get ready to go. Same as usual for head coach Scott Hetty in his Scott Fleming in his 21st season at Marion University. It'll be Savannah Harwager, the leadoff at shortstop. Batting second will be Brooke Knox, the second baseman. And the three hole will be right fielder Abby Madeer. Batting fourth, the cleanup hitter as usual, number four, Sierra Norman at first base. The catching duties in the five hole is number two, Grace Meyer. Batting sixth in left field is number three, Abby Hoffman. Designated player for Marion in game one today is Lily Wendt, number five. She bats seventh. Playing third base and wearing number eight in the eight hole in the lineup is Haley Green, who had a tremendous weekend, batting 559. And then batting ninth for Marion will be Anna Pritchett. She's starting in center field today, batting ninth. Marion's starting pitcher in game one today will be Olivia Stunkel. We'll talk more on this lineup when we come back. We're going to take a pause for the national anthem, and we'll be back for more softball here on MU Knights TV.
Marion University's Ancilla College brings exciting educational opportunities to Northern Indiana. Now you can pursue both in-demand degrees and championship dreams at a place built on faith, leadership, and career-building academics. Marion has been named one of the most innovative universities for cutting-edge changes on campus and in-course delivery with the best undergraduate teaching in the Midwest. Marion University's Ancilla College. Start here and go anywhere. Find out more by going to marion.edu/ancilla.
Still waiting? You could have been seen by an orthopedic specialist at Ortho Indy Urgent Care. Avoid the wait, cost, and drama of the ER. Ortho Indy Urgent Care. Orthopedic care without the drama. Find a location near you.
There's something that may surprise you about Marion University. It's not our Catholic faith or our Franciscan values. It's not our 5,000 students or our diversity. It's not Marion's championship athletics or our Indianapolis location. It's that Marion is home to Indiana's only college of osteopathic medicine. Marion, Indy's Catholic University.
Meet Chip. He turned a big idea into a big company. At Indiana Members Credit Union, we're helping Chip and his family grow their business. We'll help you, too, with financing to expand your venture. Because at IMCU, it's you that matters. Meet Zach. Peddling day in and day out gets tough. At Indiana Members Credit Union, we can help Zach and you drive your dream. With auto loan rates as low as 5.74% APR. Because at IMCU, it's you that matters.
Pepsi's always had great taste. Today, try great taste with zero sugar. This is the Pepsi with zero compromises. This is Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Welcome back to MU Knights TV, this production of Marion Softball brought to you by AAA Roofing. When it rains, it pours, so trust the pros at AAA Roofing. That's who we call. Game one today will feature Olivia Stunkel in the circle for the Knights. Stunkel, one of the dominant pitchers in this Crossroads League, coming into today's game. Winners of her last two outings that she's thrown. Stunkel has a win already this season against Grace. This, her 16th start of the campaign. Liv rocking a 1.23 ERA. She has thrown 85 and two-thirds of an inning, and she will face Bella Duran to lead things off here in game number one of today's doubleheader. First pitch, a strike in at 2:59 p.m. on the Eastern Sea Time. Absolutely tremendous day for softball here on campus. Stunkel ahead 1-0. And make it 1-1 now as Duran takes on the inside pitch. Duran on the season for these Lancers, batting 302. This is her 26th game, 24th start. She's 26 for 86 at the plate with four doubles. So she scored 19 runs. This ball hit high into left field, but Abby Hoffman, the left fielder, camping underneath it and records the out for out number one in the first inning to bring Stunkel now to 86 total innings on the season. Stunkel did pitch against Grace in game number one of the season series. That game back on March 12th, Marion was 12-1 at the point with the win. Stunkel threw four innings, gave up one hit and one run, struck out two. The first time she saw Grace this season, she throws a changeup in to Hallie Nett for strike one. Marion and Grace split their doubleheader back on March the 12th in a pair of run rule games. A little oddity that Marion would see a run rule defeat in game two as Hallie Nett pops this one up to Stunkel in the circle, the pitcher fielding her own position and recording the out for the second one of the frame. Marion won that first game back on March the 12th, 10-2 in five innings. They put up three runs in three of the five innings they played. But in game two of that doubleheader, it was Grace behind Jerry Ellis who won 8-0, run ruling Marion in five. It was the first time the Knights had been run ruled in a game since April. You'd have to go back to April of 2018 was the last time the Knights were run ruled in a contest. That coming back on March the 12th. Here, though, 1-0 count. Make it a 1-1 now as that ball fouled out of play by Jerry Ellis, designated player here for the Lancers. Ellis likely going to be the starting pitcher in game number two. Very solid on the year for Grace, appearing in 15 games, all his starts. With the trend continuing, that would likely be the case here. In the second act, ball on the inside corner there, 2-1 the count. Marion's defensive alignment, Abby Hoffman in left field, Anna Pretchett in center, and Abby Madeira in right. From left to right around the infield, it's Haley Green, Savannah Harwager, Brooke Knox, Sierra Norman, Grace Meyer catching Stunkel. The 2-1, a strike down the middle, comes back with a fastball, does Stunkel. Even on the count now, 2-2. Busy week coming up in Marion Athletics for the Knights. Marion scheduled to play tomorrow, Thursday, and Saturday. Weather pending, of course. Spring weather looming. Ellis takes this one for a ride to left field, but Abby Hoffman camps underneath it about 15 feet in front of the warning track for out number three. Stunkel, perfect in the first inning. She retires the side in order. It'll be Marion coming up with Harwager, Knox, and Norman or in Madeira when we come back for the bottom of the first inning on MU Knights TV.
Indiana Members Credit Union. We're invested in more than just your finances. We're invested in your future, the future of your family, the well-being of the community you live in, and in those who dream big. Until those dreams become a reality, any bank can give you a loan or open an account. At IMCU, we care about more than just dollars and cents. We care about doing things that make sense. And investing in you makes good sense to us.
Bottom of the first inning here on MU Knights TV. Big thank you to Pepsi, proud partner of the Marion Athletics Department and Marion University. Pepsi, grab a Pepsi and some friends and get in the game. Starting pitcher for Grace College here in game number two is, or sorry, game one of our two-game doubleheader today is number 14, Chloe Huff. She'll face off against shortstop Savannah Harwager on the season. Huff making her 13th appearance, 10th start. She does have one complete game and one save this season in 53 and a third inning. She's given up 25 earned runs and has struck out 30 batters. Tough test to face here. She starts off batting or pitching against Savannah Harwager of the Knights. Harwager on the season, batting .505. A tremendous mark, would be the career or single season record if it holds through. Harwager takes ball one. Great day for softball here on the Indianapolis west side. Going to be a little wet the next 2 days in the forecast. Stay tuned to MUnites.com to see what Marion softball is up to these next couple days. Harwager fouls Huff's pitch back, 1-1 the count. Also keeping tabs on Marion baseball, who's currently at Mount Vernon Nazarene right now. For those who aren't following the Marion baseball team this season, currently in fourth place in the Crossroads League and in a battle against Mount Vernon and St. Francis for that four spot. Fans, if you will note, Crossroads League tournament, top four teams get a bye into the tournament bracket. The bottom four teams, 5 through 8, will play a single elimination winner-take-all game to advance into the bracket of double elimination for the Crossroads League tournament. Marion currently in fourth. And Davis infield gets Marion out of the eighth inning, so the Knights going to take an 8-5 lead to the ninth. These games huge against Mount Vernon Nazarene. Mount Vernon currently in sixth place. Marion pseudo-tied for fourth as far as win percentage in the Crossroads League, but St. Francis did just take 3 out of 4 from Marion. So a big opportunity for the Knights baseball team here. On the diamond in front of us, Savannah Harwager, 2-2 count, takes ball low in the dirt. Huff tried to come at her with a changeup, but that ball did not reach the plate. In for a ball, 3-2 to count. Harwager, again, having a tremendous season, three triples, one home run, has walked 12 times this season. She's 53 for 105, playing all 33 games this campaign. Harwager takes this one, fouling to left, and great catch by the left fielder there. Number 27, Montana Brinks, comes out of nowhere off your screen and makes a sliding catch in left field in foul territory to retire the first out and retire Harwager. And it'll bring up number one, Brooke Knox. Knox on the season, batting .282, was up over .300 about a week and a half ago, but has seen her average tick down a few notches here these past couple weeks. The Chicago, Illinois, and Plainfield North High School product from the Illinois. Knox on the season, earning the number two spot and the number second base job. Fouls this one back, falling behind 0-2. The first time Knox played Grace this season, she went 2 for 4 in the doubleheader, drew a walk, did strike out one time in that doubleheader. Huff ahead, 0-2. Ball just a bit inside and up. Knox takes the pitch, 1-2. Multitasking a little bit, so if we're behind on balls and strikes on the screen, I do apologize, folks. The 1-2 from Huff. Change up low, 2-2 to count now. The 2-2 from Huff up high. So again, Huff works to a full count. Marion drawing the full count, trying to get their first base runner in today's game. Marion put up 3 runs the first time they saw Grace this season in the opening game. Not the most successful weekend for the Knights, though. We're up to Coach Fleming's standards. Marion going 3-1 as Knox strikes out. For the second out of the inning. Marion went 3-1. They swept Huntington on Saturday with a 1-0 and 6-2 victory. Won the first game Sunday against against St. Francis Cougars. 4-0 behind Olivia Stunkel, but in game two lost 5-4. Game two kind of being the Achilles heel for Marion so far this season. Here's Abby Medeer now batting for the Knights. Entering today's doubleheader with a .404 batting average. Who takes ball two on the inside corner. Medeer on the season, 12 doubles, 2 triples, 2 home runs. Believe she hit 1 home run over the weekend. Takes this one off the end of the bat and fouls it back. Marion's best hitter in their weekend's 4-game set on the road was Haley Green, who we'll see bat 8th later in this game, and perhaps later in this inning even if Marion can get a 2-out rally going. Medeer faces the 2-1 from Huff and swings through that fastball for strike two. Strikes against the Knights. Marion in jeopardy of going down in order here. In the first inning, the 2-2 pitch from Chloe Huff swung on into foul territory and making the play near the Marion dugout. Number 28. That is Tia O'Connor, the third baseman, makes the catch. Marion, a quick 1-2-3 as the side is retired in order. We'll head to the second inning in a scoreless contest here on MU Knights TV.
This is the Pepsi for America's best barbecue. Worthy of 100-mile detours and 1,000 likes. Looks good. This is the Pepsi for mopping, dipping, and dousing. Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you. This is the Pepsi for serious fans and serious eats. This is the Pepsi for Sundays at the ballpark and days off at your favorite pizza joint. Right, Aaron?
Best slice in New York.
Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you.
We are back for the second inning here on MU Knights TV. Big thank you to Kenna Gray working for us here up in the press box, running the scoreboard. Haley Sorrell, statistician here in today's doubleheader action. I'm Mitch Shepard, assistant athletic director for communications on the call of today's doubleheader. Multitasking as I cover the Marion baseball doubleheader for our social media accounts. Marion leading 9-5 there. Here we've got a scoreless game with number 10, Cassie Hayes, up to bat for the Grace Lancers, leading off the second inning as she takes ball one. Off to the outside corner, standing in the left-handed batter's box is Hayes, second-best hitter on this Lancer squad with a .306 batting average this season. Hayes roll over ground ball to second base. Brooke Knox makes the play for out number one in the inning. Easy 4-3 put out there to retire the first out in the second. Stunkel for Marion. Another tremendous campaign, 1.23 ERA. She's 15-1 overall this season and making her 18th appearance in today's game. She's made 2 appearances in relief this season as she misses ball one inside to batter number 28, Tia O'Connor, the third baseman. This Lancer lineup loaded with seniors and upperclassmen and experience. O'Connor, a junior from Beech Grove, Indiana. Probably has some family and friends here in the crowd today, if I had to imagine. Multiple upperclassmen for these Lancers. 5 seniors alone for Bo and Sam Coolin, co-head coaches of the Grace Lancers, husband-wife duo. Well-respected around the Crossroads League. Bo Coolin coaching over at first base today. Sam Coolin coaching out of the dugout. Also on this Lancer staff, Reef Flanagan and Bethany Carpenter, assistant coaches. Stunkel behind 2-1 to O'Connor. Make it 3-1 as she misses fastball low. Neither team with a base runner yet today in this contest. Grace looking for their first as O'Connor digs back into the plate. And that's a called strike on the inner half of the plate. Stunkel liked the pitch. O'Connor did not. So it'll be a 3-2 count now. As O'Connor was thinking walk there. Has to settle back into the plate. Stunkel going to try to take advantage of it. But she misses a low and in. Changeup does not get the job done. As that's going to be the first base runner for either team in today's contest. As O'Connor draws the 6-pitch walk. And that'll bring up number 21, Madison Ganey. Ganey on the season, batting .294, fifth best hitter in this Lancer lineup. 26th appearance, 21st start as she makes the start for the Lancers. In center field today, taking ball one. That pitch fouled back and away toward the tennis courts behind us, right over the head of Mike Holman, Marion track and field coach, who's watching before his practice today. And congratulations to Marion Mike head coach Mike Holman, who has announced his retirement from Marion University. 12 years of coaching at Marion, 46 overall in Mike Holman's career. One of the greatest coaches in Marion University history by far. 14 individual national champions, 2 top 5 finishes at the NAIA championships. 22-time coach of the year in the Crossroads League is Mike Holman. We wish him congratulations, and of course, the Knights still have a long way to go before the end of the year, but we will wish him well as he sails into retirement this spring. Holman, one of 2 coaching changes at Marion, as Scott Heddy, Marion men's basketball head coach, takes the head coaching role at University of Indianapolis. Excuse me, swing fouled in the play and back. Count stays 2-2. Swing and a miss, strike 3. Ganey swings through that pitch. Unable to catch up to Stunkel's fastball. And 2 outs now here in the second inning. That strikeout will bring up Bree Gardiner catching today for Grace. Not the strongest season at the plate for the senior product here. Rather, junior product from Beaumont, California. Gardiner takes ball 1 on the inside corner. Gardiner on the season, 4-for-30 at the plate, batting .133 on the campaign. Did contribute in the .350 batting average against Marion in their doubleheaders back earlier this season. Strike called, but throw back from Meyer to first base at Norman. Not in time as O'Connor easily back into the bag. Foul ball here from Gardiner. One of the many Lancer names you get familiar with when you see a team twice a season. When these teams see each other 4 times overall. Hard hit ground ball to shortstop. Harwager, tough play and makes the out. Tremendous play from Savannah Harwager. Fields the ground ball cleanly, gets the out at first or at second base to Knox, and that will be the 3rd out of the inning as Marion limits the walk and retires the side. We're scoreless at Sierra Norman leading off for Marion when we come back. members of the Marion football team walking to practice off your screen here in the as we get set for the bottom of the second inning. Marion football closing up their spring ball this week. And it's Sierra Norman leading off things here on the diamond for the Marion softball team. Norman, another strong season for her, batting .351 entering play today. She's 33 of 94 at the dish. Three doubles, three triples. Home run numbers are down this season, but she does have four on the year. Would be a good time for one here. Was thinking it, but was under that pitch and fouls that one back and out of play for strike one. And strike two against Norman. Stormin' Norman at the plate. As the fans call out to her. 0-2 pitch from Chloe Huff comes in. Change up outside for ball one. Keeping up with the Marion baseball team. They're in the ninth inning with a 9-5 lead against Mount Vernon. Deacon Spencer in for the final three outs. And after giving up a single, Spencer gets a rollover double play and then gets Ryder Minnick to fly out to center field to end things as Marion's going to take game one of today's doubleheader, 9-5. Congrats to those Knights over in Mount Vernon, Ohio. And congrats to Davis Enfield getting the win on the mound, pitching eight innings in his return after 6 weeks off. Big win for the Knights. Marion softball looking to get another big win here at home. But not going to start here as Huff gets Norman the strike out for the first out in the inning. And that'll bring up Grace Meyer to the dish. A couple sirens in the background for Meyer as she digs into the batter's box. Lefty swing, righty thrower. Marion in their gray uniforms today. Blue Crossroads League patch on the left sleeve. Marion across the chest with in navy with gold accents along with navy numbers and gold trim around the numerals. Grace in the red jerseys, black pants. White Grace across the chest with white numerals, black outline. 1-1 the count against Meyer. Huff, who does carry the best ERA on this Lancer squad, looking to lower it here again. She's got a 1-1 count. Meyer calls for time. Huff was perfect in the first inning of today's game. Marion did not see Huff their first time playing them. It was Kirsten Ficus, and Alexis Bergman. Who pitched in the first contest. Those sirens must have been for our campus as we see a truck in the background. Meyer singles up the middle off of Huff's glove, and that'll be Marion's first hit of the game. So Marion going to get a runner on base here in the second inning. For Abby Hoffman. Hope everything's all right as you see an emergency first responder rolling up on campus. We will see the action, though, in the background as they look like they are heading into Kaito Wagner Hall. Abby Hoffman under this pitch here. High and deep to left field, but caught at the track. Great play out in center field. That ball just hung and carried as it traveled out to the fence. Madison Ganey making the catch there at the wall. Retiring Hoffman. She took that pitch for a ride. Maybe another park, another time of day, a little bit more wind. That ball gone for Hoffman. But right there, nope. So Hoffman will stay shy of hitting her first collegiate home run. It will be Lily Wint's turn now. Marion trying to score a run, but they have a runner on first base in Grace Meyer. Wint, Bishop Chittard product at the plate, swings this one. T.O. O'Connor makes the snag and makes the throw. Great effort again by third baseman number 28, Tia O'Connor, as she retires the final out in the inning, making a great play ranging to her left and throwing across the diamond for the final out in the inning. We're going to be scoreless through two on MU Knights TV.
Pepsi's always had great taste. Today, try great taste with zero sugar. This is the Pepsi with zero compromises. This is Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Back on MU Knights TV for the top of the third inning here of Marion softball taking on Grace College. Marion in the gray, Grace in the red and black. And it's pitcher versus pitcher at the plate. Chloe Huff batting to lead things off for the Lancers in the eight hole today. Takes ball one. Huff on the season, 154 when she gets the chance to bat. She is 2-for-13 on the season. She has scored a run and has doubled once as she takes a ball. 2-0 the count. Stunkel hitless so far today, but she has walked a batter. Stunkel with a combined no-hitter this season already. We saw that 2 weeks ago from the day's date on MU Knights TV when they played Bethel. That pitch fouled back. Huff did see action her first time playing Marion as a DP. That was in the 8-0 win in game two of the Marion's and Grace's season opening, or Crossroads League opening doubleheader. Pitch fouled away. Huff went 1-for-2 against Marion. That was against Jayla Gilliam and Macy Cohn. Here facing Stunkel for the first time this season. That pitch misses, ball three. Full count now. Not the first time we've seen a full count today in today's game. Stunkel going to try to get the strikeout. Does not. Instead, ball fouled near the Marion tarp in left field. And we'll do it again here at 3-2. Two once again, swing and a miss. Stunkel goes upstairs and gets her counterpart Huff to strike out. That's the first out of the inning and the strikeout for Stunkel, her second in today's game. Montana Brinks the batter now, playing left field for these Grace Lancers, taking ball one upstairs. Brinks on the year, batting 227, usual left fielder for these Lancers. Swing and a miss, strike one. Brinks from Harvard, Illinois, Harvard High School. Not to be confused with the Harvard out in Boston. Meyer tries to frame that one, but to her... willingness, it was not called a strike. 2-1 the count. Brinks, when she faced Stunkel earlier this season, went 0-for-2 at the plate, taking a strike on the outer half there. In fact, the only hit Stunkel gave up in that game one that Marion saw against Grace earlier this season, both came from Caitlin Seagrave, I believe. Yep, Caitlin Seagrave had both hits in that game. Strike three down the middle. And that'll be the third strikeout of today's game for Stunkel. Finishing that thought, Caitlin Seagrave had both hits against Marion in their first meeting this season. One off of Stunkel, one off of Lauren Mayer. So two away now, and the lineup rolls back over for Bella Duran here in the top of the third inning. And Duran, just like that, lines out the third base. We were getting ready to talk to you about how she flew out to left, but she lines out the third, and that'll be retired as Marion. 1-2-3 in the third inning. Bottom of the third coming up on AM Unites TV.
Marion University's Ancilla College brings exciting educational opportunities to Northern Indiana. Now you can pursue both in-demand degrees and championship dreams at a place built on faith, leadership, and career-building academics. Marion has been named one of the most innovative universities for cutting-edge changes on campus and in-course delivery with the best undergraduate teaching in the Midwest. Marion University's Ancilla College. Start here and go anywhere. Find out more by going to marion.edu/ancilla.
Bottom of the third inning here on MU Knights TV, and Haley Green will lead things off. Third baseman from Cicero, Indiana. Strong stick in the Marion lineup this past weekend, batting 556 in four games played. That's 5-for-9 for those of you that aren't math wizards out there. I know I am not. That's why I have the stats in front of me to tell me that she hit 556. She was Marion's nominee for Crossroads League Player of the Week. Hit her first home run of the season on Saturday at St. Francis. 1-1 now the count. It'll be Pritchett and Harwager to follow here. Coach Scott Fleming would love to see Haley Green get on base. She's increased that batting average at 556, brought her over to the 300 threshold for the first time here this season, now batting 301 on the year. She sees a changeup from Huff that misses away. 2-1 the count. Here comes a 2-1 from Huff. Called strike down the middle. Green refusing to swing at that pitch. 2-2 count. Tremendous day for softball. Temperatures now reaching 72 here on the city's west side. Chloe Huff chases, or gets Green to chase. Strike three swinging. Green just swung through that pitch on the rise ball. And the first out retired. Now as center fielder Anna Pritchett digs into the plate. Pritchett batting 346 on the season. She's played in 27 of the 33 games for Marion this season, carrying a 346 batting average. Pritchett comebacker right to the pitcher on the ground and out by a step. Great hustle from Pritchett, but that ball hit too hard and at the right location for her to get on base.
Now batting number 30, Savannah Harwager.
Marion has their full complement of coaching staff here available today. Pitching coach Brianna Smith in the dugout. First base, coaching first base now, Hannah Williams. And coaching third, head coach Scott Fleming. Lainey Horan also in the dugout. Deepest this Marion coaching staff has been in quite some time. I've been here long enough at Marion to just remember the days when it just used to be Coach Fleming and then a player coaching first base. That player normally was Morgan Bertrand. Harwager stabs bunt at the 1-0 pitch, and that ball trickles back foul. Would have been a base hit had she safely gotten the bunt down. Marion 26-6 overall on the season. in a different spot in the Crossroads League. Normally, a four-loss season would be what you would see from Marion, at least these past couple years in Crossroads League play. Marion, four losses already through 18 games. They've got 18 left to play. Ball three. Changeup misses out. Harwager staying away from that one. Marion currently in second place, but going to have to battle Spring Arbor as the season carries on. The 3-1 pitch, Harwager hammers this ball on the ground through the middle of the field, and that's going to be a base hit for the Knights. Just their second of the game. Both going right back to the pitcher.
Now batting number one, Brooke Knox.
And we'll see what Marion can do here now. Two outs away with a runner on first base. Harwager, a candidate to steal anytime she touches base. And will be in prime position to take second here. I'll have to see what kind of arm Gardiner has. Chloe Huff, two outs, retired. Harwager does steal. Gardiner's throw sailing wide of second base. Harwager easily in for a stolen base. And as the dugout will say, was that Lightning McQueen? No, it's Savannah Harwager. Or something to that effect. Runner in scoring position now for Knox, who has been struggling at the dish. But a well-tipped base hit here could change the thing, could change the fortune for her. Ahead in the count, 2-0. Knox is just going to tattoo this one to left field. That ball off the bottom of the fence, and Knox standing up with a double. That ball had some juice on it as that thing was hammered to left field. Thought it was going to go gone, but it did not. And that, an RBI double for Brooke Knox. Marion leads it now 1-0. Back-to-back doubles for the Knights. The offense starting to roll here in the third inning. Abby Madeer, Brooke Knox trading places. And we're going to get a time and a visit on the mound. That's two quick runs for the Knights. We'll see what happens here after this mound visit. If pitching coach and assistant or associate head coach Sam Coolin decides to change pitchers or not. One count here. Huff still pitching for the Lancers after the mound visit. Gets Norman to chase that one. 1-2 the count. Marion with a big inning so far here. Three hits, scoring two runs, all with two outs. Norman puts this one in play. Ground ball to shortstop, and that's going to be a base hit. Well hit ball by Norman into the 5-6 hole. Howie Nett unable to make the play. That'll put runners on the corners for the Knights with two outs. And a strong hitting Grace Meyer at the dish. Meyer entered today's doubleheader batting .411. She is the team leader in doubles. Entering play, currently tied with Abby Madeer after her double here, her last at bat. 2-0 the lead for Marion on MU Knights TV. Marion trying to break this one wide open. Norman will steal. Meyer flies into left field. That ball just short of the fence. That ball caught by Brinks in left center field at the track. But damage done. Marion, 2 runs in the fourth. We're going to take a break on MU Knights TV. Howie Nett, the leadoff hitter for Grace in the fourth inning, and she flies out
now
to center field
nine,
for the first out. Now bringing up Jerry Ellis. Action warming happening now in the Grace bullpen. It's Sage Ladig getting loose, likely to come in at some point in this game from Fortville, Indiana. Went to Hamilton Southeastern High School. Stunkel's first pitch, a ball to Ellis. One one the count here. Stunkel facing Ellis. Jam shot off the end of the bat. Someone's going to have to field this one, and Stunkel will. However, she's rather Ellis safe at first. That ball just kind of spun and hung around the first baseline in no man's land between Stunkel and Norman. That will break up the no-hit bid that Stunkel had active. Some new faces helping us out here on the broadcast. Ella Collier taking over on the ones and twos on the computer. Aaliyah Evans stepping in to take some photos down on the field. You can see those later on MUKnights.com. Check out our photo galleries there. Cassie Hayes now batting first baseman. She's got a runner on first base in Ellis. And one out retired here. She golfs this one in the left field. Abby Hoffman has to move a little bit to make the play, but Hoffman's racing in and makes the catch for the second out in the inning. Two away now, Tia O'Connor, the batter for Grace. O'Connor has made some tremendous defensive plays today. Has not as produced as much juice at the dish as she fouls the first pitch back. O'Connor, her first at bat. In fact, there was no juice to obtain. She drew a walk her first time up an inning ago. Tia batting 291 on the season. Takes ball one inside, 1-1 the count. Marion and Grace 1-1, even on their season series. The Knights won the first meeting on March the 12th. Grace won the second, both five-inning contests. Here, changeup misses low and out, ball two. Stunkel didn't seem to like the pitch, or maybe the call from her catcher, Meyer. Stone Cold toes the rubber. And O'Connor slings and slaps this one in the right field. Madeer narrowly misread the play, but able to readjust, get underneath the ball, and record the out. Side retired, base hit stranded. Marion leads 2-0 on MU Knights TV.
Meet Kate. She has a lot to juggle. Family, work, it can lead to trying days and tired nights. But we know Kate, and at Indiana Members Credit Union, we know at some point, her space at a premium life may change. IMCU is here to help Kate and you find your space. Now, add on or remodel with an introductory rate of 3.9% APR on a home equity line of credit. Today, it's all about Kate. Tomorrow, it's all about you. Because at IMCU, it's you that matters.
We are back on MU Knights TV for the bottom of the fourth. One of the outfielders who just made one of those catches, Abby Hoffman, leads things off here for Marion in the fourth inning. Hoffman flew out to deep left field her first time up, unable to reach base. Didn't even have a chance to talk about Hoffman's season so far as the freshman from Roncalli. She swung at the first pitch her first time up, takes ball one there. Hoffman batting .359 this season. Batting .359 on the year is Hoffman. She's played in now 30 games. Hoffman takes strike one, 2-1 the count. Two-one pitch misses for a ball. Count moves to 3-1. And Huff misses for a five-pitch walk. Hoffman reaching base to lead off the inning. And she's just going to ditch the mask. Not too often you see the pitcher ditch the mask as if that was the problem. Regardless, the walk will bring up Lily Wendt, number 5 for Marion, from Bishop Chittard here in Indianapolis, right down Kessler Boulevard. First pitch Wendt sees in this at bat is a strike. Didn't really like it. Did number 5. The 0-1 misses high for ball 1. Marion looking to add to their lead here in the fourth inning. Marion also trying to beat some weather. There is a chance of rain later today that we could see in game 2. Hope not. Hoping you just get a pair of softball games in as Wendt tattoos this one to left field. Basket catch by Brinks in left field. And if Grace is smart to appeal this, they will get Abby Hoffman out at second. Yep, and here comes the appeal play to second base. Hoffman is going to be out on the double play. Missed call by the umpire. So what happened there, folks, for those that aren't familiar with the rule, Hoffman rounded second and didn't, and because she did that when the ball was caught, she needs to touch second base on her tagging effort. However, Hoffman lucky there that the umpire did not see that. I'm right there with Bo and Sam Coolin, head coaches of Grace. That should have been an out inning over. Instead, just the second out, and now Haley Green up to bat. Gosh, those balls have Marion has been bashing the softball to left field out by the warning track. Brinks has done a tremendous job out there today in this game, limiting Marion's offense. A lot of other times, you'll see balls drop for base hits there. Haley Green, another ball hit to the warning track, caught for the second out. So now we have two outs away. So another fly ball out to the center field line, or to the outfield fence, and it brings up Anna Pritchett. Pritchett, not necessarily the power hitter to take this ball to center field. More of the slap it on the ground as she stares back at ball one. Pritchett, Greenwood Woodsman in high school, say that five times fast. Takes ball two. A big win, as we mentioned earlier, for Marion baseball in game one of their doubleheader today. They are underway already in game two. One the count. Hoffman running and a base hit through the left side. Hoffman takes advantage of it, slides in safely to third. Pritchett on the throw to second. Marion two on and two outs, both in scoring position. Chance to get some more runs here for the Knights as their number one hitter. Not only in the lineup, but on the season, up to bat with Savannah Hartwager stepping in the box. Hartwager takes ball one. Today, one for two. She started the rally in the last inning with a two-out single. Here, looking for another two-out hit. Base hit anywhere in the outfield would score two runs most likely with the speed of Hoffman and Pritchett. Hartwager taking ball two outside. Huff might try to play around Hartwager here. Pitch around the Marion leader in hitting. Instead comes right at Hartwager. This ball high in the air. And T.O. O'Connor running behind the plate to make the catch in foul territory. Hartwager just camped underneath that one and unable to put the ball in play. Two on, but a wasted opportunity for the Knights. We're going to go to the fifth. 2-0, Marion leads. Getting some goosebumps here as we start the fifth inning here on MU Knights TV. It's Stunkel with the 2-0 lead, facing off against number 21, Ganey. Madison Ganey from Mooresville, Indiana, just outside the 465 pipeline. Mentioned earlier this game, I'm paying attention to multiple contests here today. Marion baseball in game two of their doubleheader at Mount Vernon. big-time opportunity for the Knights to try to get a game in the standings in the Crossroads League as they play a big series against Bethel this weekend. Stunkel misses there, 2-1 the count. Haley Green makes the play, pops it over to herself. First out of the inning recorded by the spunky third baseman from Cicero and Hamilton Heights High School.
Now batting number 12, Bree Gardiner.
Swing and a miss from Gardiner as Stunkel trying to work quick here in the fifth. This game not even an hour old. We're at the 55-minute mark since we saw first pitch at 2:59 on the Eastern time zone. Gardiner hammers this one, and you can kiss that one goodbye. Marion's seen plenty of balls hit toward the to the warning track, but that one a home run for the Lancers. And that'll cut the lead in half. For Stunkel, just the third home run she's given up this season, now tied for the team lead in home runs against. She sees her shutout dissipate.
Now batting number 14, Chloe Huff.
And for Gardiner, her second home run of the season, that'll help out that 133 average. Her ninth RBI on the season. That'll also improve that 267 slugging as pitcher Chloe Huff takes ball one. Huff still in the game here pitching. Has been in a pair of jams throughout the contest today, but still in the game and still in line here, looking to help herself as she fouls that pitch back and out of play over our heads in the dugout. And Huff doing her chance to help there. That ball hit through the 5-6 hole. Base hit on the left side, and that will give a runner here for the Lancers as they look to extend
now
some offense here. Strike one now against Montana Brinks, who's made a couple of outs in left field. This ball fouled toward Marion's dugout for strike two. Another foul ball down the left field line. No action in the Marion bullpen at the moment. As game one, traditionally all Stunkel. 0-2 count. Double play would be well-timed here for Marion as they look to try to get their offense rolling again. Has a chance instead. Nope, Knox going to take the safe out at first base rather than turn and make the difficult play at second. And the routine 4-3 retires the second out here in
now
the inning.
Number one, Bella Duran.
And that's just one out away from moving to the bottom of the fifth inning. And we're going to see a lineup change perhaps. Sam Coolin coming to the plate. And we're going to get a pinch runner for Grace. It's number 26. And I worked on her name earlier, the Muncie, Indiana, Daleville High School product, Callie Kalekameko, Kamala Coco, Como. I will work on that here. Tricky name here, but Callie, as we'll call her, number 26, pinch running for the pitcher, out at second base is Grace sensing an opportunity to score here with Bella Duran up to bat. Duran today has flew out twice to the left side. Once a fly out to Abby Hoffman in left field, the other a line drive snared by number 8 Haley Green at third base. Strike one. Grace entered today in ninth place in the Crossroads League with a 9-17 overall record. Grace, 5-13, could really stand to grab a, or needs a win here if they want to make that play-in in the Crossroads League tournament. They're one game back of Huntington, who's 6-15. Tricky play, this ball off of Harwager. Play at the plate coming. And safe. Wild sequence there. That ball, an error off of Harwager. Duran into second safe. And Kamale Como scores from second, makes it to third easily, and beats the play at the plate, slides in under the tag, and just like that, this game is tied with an unearned run crossing the plate. Make it the eighth error of the season, or rather ninth error of the season for Harwager at shortstop. Ball is a rifle. But you expect the senior the fifth-year senior shortstop to make that routine play. And a line drive there caught. Harwager makes up for it. But the game tied. Damage done. Grace scores two in the top of the fifth. And we're tied on MU Knights TV.
Meet Zach. Day and night, rain or shine, even just out for a spin, Zach gets around. But we know Zach, and at Indiana Members Credit Union, we know he's been saving up to trade up. IMCU is here to help Zach and you drive your dream. Now get financing as low as 5.74% APR on a new or used vehicle. Today, it's all about Zach. Tomorrow, it's all about you. Because at IMCU, it's you that matters.
Well, damage done in the top of the fifth inning as Grace comes back with two runs. Solo home run and unearned run. All started with Chloe Huff's one out single. Huff does re-enter now. She's opted for the visor this inning. As Brooke Knox hammers this pitch to left field, another warning track-esque power. Ball caught by Brinks in left field. Knox is hitting it well, just isn't hitting it where she needs to. She does have the double, but that ball a flyout to left. Bring up Abby Madeira, who doubled the right center the last time she saw her chance at the plate. Ball one here. A congrats out to the Marion baseball, or rather men's golf team, earning a win over Milligan today in their tournament. Brandon Hefner, the overall individual winner, along with Nolan Porter placing fourth. And rather, this is just true domination by the Marion men's golf team here. You've got Brandon Hefner first in their tournament at the Midway Invite. Nolan Potter fourth. Weston Ogden and Lane Zedrick tied for fifth. Augie Mann in ninth. Great outing by the men's golf team as Madeira, who was up 3-0, takes strike one. Birds chirping in the background, sounds of spring. Here at the diamond today, Madeira chases the outside pitch. This ball drifting, and caught by the flex player in right field. course, our flex player in this game is 33, Ashlyn Irwin. Another mound visit for Sam Coolin. Going through how they want to pitch to Sierra Norman here. Marion's cleanup hitter. Norman on the day, base hit and a strikeout. Base hit the last time, an infield single that was snagged on the left side. Could have been more, but great play by shortstop Hallie Nett to limit just a single. Mound visit over. Here is Norman at the plate. 351 on the campaign, 500 in the game. Takes ball one outside. Another ball outside. The mound visit not too kind to Huff as she is down 0-2. Rather 2-0 the count. And Norman swinging, missing there. 2-1. There's a pocket cell of rain coming our way here at some point throughout today. Hope to get as much softball in as possible. Norman hits this one high in the right center field, and drifting over is Ganey. She makes the catch, and we're going to head to the sixth inning. Tied 2-2 on MU Knights TV.
Indiana Members Credit Union. We're invested in more than just your finances. We're invested in your future, the future of your family, the well-being of the community you live in, and in those who dream big. Until those dreams become a reality, any bank can give you a loan or open an account. At IMCU, we care about more than just dollars and cents. We care about doing things that make sense. And investing in you makes good sense to us.
Top of the sixth inning and a tied game, 2-2 the score. This game an hour and 7 minutes old. Stunkel misses ball one outside as Jerry Ellis steps in. And Ellis tattoos this ball to left over the shoulder of Abby Hoffman. This ball in for a double. Leadoff double to left, and that's going to get Grace an early base runner. As Sam Coolin coming to the lineup card once again, it's going to be a pinch runner on the bases. And we're going to see a pinch runner, number 30, coming into the contest. That is Caitlin Seagrave, Fishers, Indiana product. So Grace threatening here in the sixth inning. Lead off double and heart of the order up to bat. It's Cassie Hayes, the 306 hitter. She's got 26 hits on the season entering the doubleheader. Make that a 27th and 20 and an RBI single, as that's going to give Grace the go-ahead run. Hayes now 1-for-3 on the game, and she's going to get an RBI single, driving Grace in front. We're going to get another.
Number 28,
and now we're going to get another change, another courtesy runner or pinch runner for Grace. It's 32. Maisie Harlow. And Marion going to call for time here as well as Brina Smith, the pitching coach, comes out to the circle to talk to her pitcher, Stunkel. So Marion in a bit of trouble here. So Marion in a bit of trouble here, trailing 3-2. Stunkel on the day, she's given up 5 hits, 3 runs, 2 of them earned. She has struck out 3 in her 70 pitches that she has thrown. But the hits all well-timed for Grace. Stunkel had a no-hitter going through 3 innings, 3 1/3 rather, until a base hit by Jerry Ellis broke up the no-hit bid. The runs didn't start scoring, though, until the 5th inning, just about 10-15 minutes ago, when Bree Gardiner hit a solo home run. Things started to spiral there when Chloe Huff had a base hit. Her pinch runner would come around to score on an error. And now Grace, who scored the last 3 runs, they've got a double and single, and Stunkel misses away with ball 1. Marion has been in these situations before this season, but normally not behind Stunkel's right arm. Stunkel going to get an out here. Ball hit high in the sky to first base, and Sierra Norman camps under it for out 1.
Now batting number 21, Maddie Ganey.
Marion hoping to try to limit the damage here to just 1 run. It's going to be Ganey, number 21, batting. Seagrave over at first base, or rather Harlow, in a sprinter stance. Swing and a miss for strike 1. Tapper to shortstop. Harwager only plays first. Makes the play in time. Beats the throw by makes the play with a 1 step to spare. Gets the 6-3 ground out. 2 outs here in the inning.
Now batting number 12, Bree Gardiner.
And as the action's been picking up here, Marion Baseball picking up their action in Ohio. Pearson Barnes, a 3-run home run in the top of the 2nd inning. Pushing Marion in front 3-0. Barnes, who by his own accord would say he struggled this weekend, batting 0-83, makes up for that poor performance with a 3-run homer for the Knights. Keep tabs on that as we go here today. Marion trailing 3-2 to Grace in the top, or the top of the 6th inning. Stunkel fires in strike 2 on the changeup to Bree Gardiner, who last time up took Stunkel deep to left field for a home run. Ball sailing out beyond the scoreboard, down toward the 2nd tree in center field. Time called by Gardiner in the box. Changeup misses low, 1-2. Gardiner swings late at the changeup by Stunkel. 4-3 the routine putout. Marion gets out of the inning, limiting the damage to just 1. But Grace is now in front 3-2. We'll be back for more on MU Knights TV.
There's something that may surprise you about Marion University. It's not our Catholic faith or our Franciscan values. It's not Marion's championship athletics or our Indianapolis location. it's that Marion is home to Indiana's only college of osteopathic medicine. Marion, Indy's Catholic University.
Grace Meyer, the leadoff batter for Marion in the sixth inning. Marion, six outs to play with here if they want to try to get the win here in game number one of today's doubleheader. Meyer on the day, 1-for-2 at the plate. Flew out to center field her last time up. This time takes the changeup from Chloe Huff in for strike one. Sitting back on that pitch, well done by Meyer. Might be the last time Meyer gets a chance at the plate today, pending a rally for Marion. She takes ball one outside, 1-1, the count now leveled. Meyer entered this doubleheader, batting .411 on the season. 31 base hits overall on the campaign for her. Spinning changeup, swung on and popped into shallow center field. Belle Duran drifts back and makes the catch in the Bermuda Triangle for out one.
Now batting number three, Abby Hoffman.
Batting now, Abby Hoffman with her doot 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 Dora lineup walk-up music at the plate. Hoffman, who flew out to left her first time up, walked her last time, reached third in the fourth inning as Anna Pritchett reached second. Marion, though, unable to score in that fourth inning with Harwager fouling back behind the plate. Hoffman, hits on the ground to third, and it's safe. Hoffman running through that one. O'Connor's made tremendous play after tremendous play today at third base, but that time just unable to get the throw in time to Hayes at first. And that's going to be an infield single for Hoffman. So maybe that's the spark for the Knights here as Lily Wentz up to bat. One of the many flyouts to left field. Today, does Wendt have? She's 0-for-2. She's grounded out to third as well. Takes that for ball two.
Bottom of the first inning, we just need to flip an out.
Okay.
You gave it to, like, when Abby flew out, you put it on center, it should be left.
Okay.
Yeah, so whenever you get a chance.
Went tattoos this one to left field, but another line drive fly ball out. Montana Brinks is a just vacuum out there in left field. She's caught everything that's come her way. And they're the second out in the inning. Brinks' confidence started when she made that sliding catch in left field to end the first inning. Haley Green now batting, 0-for-2 in the game. Had a strong weekend where she batted .556. That's now the fifth mound visit today between catcher or coach. Not sure what the limitation is here, but I have to feel that Grace is running out of visits. Low scoring 3-2 contest. Green batting about .290 overall this season when you factor in her 0-for-2 start today. Fouling this one away. Anna Pritchett in the on deck circle for Marion. Hoffman takes a big secondary lead at first base as Green swings through that pitch. Marion needing Green to get on any way possible if they can. 1-2 count, Huff well ahead. pretty pitch down the middle, just a bit upstairs. Green takes that one, 2-2. Run it back here, all twos on the scoreboard. Huff's pitch, just a bit outside. And an errant throw back from the catcher, and Hoffman takes advantage of it. Lazy throw back from Gardiner to the pitcher, and Huff just not catching it. Hoffman swiping second there on the throw. Three-two, runner in scoring position for Green. Base hit could score the speedy outfielder. Instead, Green going to take ball four.
Now batting number nine, Anna Pritchett.
Coach Scott Fleming going to keep Anna Pritchett in the lineup here. Took a couple looks at his assistant coaches on whether to make a move as a pinch runner or not, or a pinch hitter rather, and they're going to stick with Green. Rather stick with Pritchett following Green's walk. Pritchett takes strike one. Hoffman's getting a big lead out at second base. If she wanted to, theoretically, she could probably beat a throw from the shortstop who's going to have to trail the play. Pritchett fouling this one back, caught by Gardiner, side retired. So Marion, two runners on, but no damage here. We're going to head to the sixth or the seventh inning. Marion trailing 3-2 on MU Knights TV.
This is the Pepsi for America's best barbecue. Worthy of 100 mile detours and 1,000 likes. Looks good. This is the Pepsi for mopping, dipping, and dousing. Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you. This is the Pepsi for serious fans and serious eats. This is the Pepsi for Sundays at the ballpark and days off at your favorite pizza joint. Right, Aaron?
Best slice in New York.
Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you.
Top of the seventh, and starting pitcher Chloe Huff leads things off. She takes strike one from Stunkel, who now is in the Huff now in position to get the win. Stunkel in line to take the loss. O-2 pitch. Goes through Myers' wickets. 1-2 now the count. Huff, tapper up the middle. Ranging play from Harwager. Great throw over the middle, and she makes the out. Great play from Harwager, who had to make the throw from the second base side of the field, and the shortstop gets the first out in the inning. Well, if Marion's going to try to do something, they might want to try to avoid hitting it in the air their next time up to bat. Marion, out of their 18 outs, have retired in the sky 14 times today. Rather, 13 times. Only once or twice has the ball been hit on the ground for an out for Marion. Stunkel works ahead 0-1 the count. Marion will have the top of their order coming up to the plate when they next come up, as Brinks swings and misses at that one for strike two. Brinks, who's made tons of plays in left field today, 0 for 2 at the plate, takes ball one outside. The pitcher Huff for Grace, who just grounded out to short, likely to finish this contest 1 for 3 batting. Changeup hung in the air a little bit. Stunkel laughs at it, and we do it again here at 2-2. This ball fouled back behind us. Strike, or count remains rather, 2-2. Two-two pitch, another changeup inside and low. Full count now. This ball hammered up the right center alleyway, and that will be a one-out single for Montana Brinks, who gets her first hit of the day. Try to work on that 227 batting average. Well, the hit rolls over the lineup for Bella Duran, who reached last time on an error. Duran taking strike one here. Swings and misses at that one. Filthy changeup from Stunkel. Oh, to the count. Stunkel going to try to work quickly through this one. Fires in another changeup. This ball hit down toward the fence in the tarp in left field. Durant's hit everything to the left side of the field today. Error at shortstop is how she reached base. She's flown out to left and lined out to third. Stunkel way outside with that one. Wild pitch will allow Brinks to move up to second base. So now runner in scoring position for the Lancers. The 1-2, foul to the Marion bullpen. Roll back the count here at 1-2 as Caroline Roop tracks that one down, out of play. Great vantage point of the softball field and the layout of the land from the press box here. Stunkel shaking off the first sign from Meyer. Fires back, changeup, hit up the middle, base hit to center. Norman cuts the throw in from Anna Pritchett. And a base hit for Duran, who's now 1 for 4 in the game.
Number 11, Holly Nett.
So runners on the corners here for the Lancers with Hallie Nett up to bat. Strike one. Nett on the day, 0 for 3, popped up to Stunkel in the circle, flew out the center and lined out the short. That line out the short ended the fifth inning when Grace scored their two runs to tie the game. Double play, what a job, Haley Green. Nett lines out to third and then Brinks, wrong place, wrong time. Green applies the tag right away. So two quick outs like that. Maybe that's the spark Marion needs. They trail 3-2. We're going to head to the bottom of the seventh. It's do or die time on MU Knights TV.
always had great taste. Today, try great taste with zero sugar. This is the Pepsi with zero compromises. This is Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Do or die time for the Knights here on MU Knights TV. Bottom of the seventh inning, Marion trailing 3-2 to the Grace Lancers. Marion currently in second place in the Crossroads League standings. Grace in ninth place. This could be a big loss for Marion if they were to suffer it. They would fall back to near a second place tie with Spring Arbor. Marion does have the double advantage of a sweep of Spring Arbor earlier this season. Harwager takes ball one there. Spring Arbor just swept Grace over the weekend on Saturday. Those games played at Coach Phil Dick Field in Winona Lake. Harwager flies this one in the sky, hits the top of the dugout, nearly lands in the gator behind the dugout. Caroline wins it. 1-1 count. Harwager fakes bunt. Ball went over the plate. Two-one pitch. Harwager puts it on the ground, and it's going to be a base hit, bunt single. O'Connor, nothing she could do with that one other than throw it to first. Harwager safely in at first base, and now it's Brooke Knox, who always a candidate for a sacrifice play. Knox on the season has seven successful sacrifice bunt attempts, two successful sack flies. See if Harwager tries to steal beforehand. She will not. Takes ball one. Well, if you're Marion and Coach Scott Fleming, you're in the point of the lineup where you want to be at if you want to try to, you know, win this game or at least tie it. You're at the top of the order. Knox shows bunt again. Puts it down. Third base currently unoccupied, but O'Connor back. Sacrifice done. 1-4. Good job by Knox to move her teammate over as Huff makes the out at first base. And we'll see another visit from Sam Coolin to the mound. Abby Madeer, the batter for Marion. Sierra Norman on deck. And if it gets to that point, you would look at potentially Grace Meyer, Abby Hoffman, depending on how deep this inning goes, if you even need to go that far. Madeer on the season, slugging .615 entering this doubleheader. She's 1-for-3 in the game. She's flown out to right. She's flown out to left. She's doubled the center. So she sprayed it all across the field. Spray chart looking pretty active today. Team leader in stolen bases on second base, Harwager. 20 of those so far this season. Here we go, one out. Chloe Huff's pitch to Abby Madeer. First pitch in for a ball. We had sunshine earlier, clouds drifting now over the field here. Mentioned there is some weather in the forecast for later today. You hope that to get out of the games before that weather would come into play. Madeer going to the right side. This ball does drop foul. Madeer late on that swing, gets fortunate that that ball drops just in the foul territory. Bella Duran had a shot at it, unable to make the play though. 1-1 the count. Madeer, two home runs on the season. Takes ball two inside. Does also have two doubles and 13 doubles and two triples. 40 RBI. Her 41st would look pretty good for Marion, as it could as it would tie the game. If she were to get a 42nd, it would win the game. Madeer fouls this one, back and out of play, 2-2 down the count. Running it back at 2-2. Madeer hammers this one to left, but just foul. That ball was on a line and into the corner, but it goes foul by about 12 feet or so. Probably the worst place to hit it in this park today is left field, with how well Montana Brinks has been playing out there. Madeer does get new life here with a 2-2 count. Changeup misses low. Harwager thinks about third, but decides against it. Three-two. This ball hit on the ground, a base hit. Harwager rounding third, and she will score. And Madeer misses an opportunity twice. RBI single that will tie the game, but Coach Scott Fleming upset with her, with his right fielder, as she misses two opportunities to potentially swipe second. Brinks just had some trouble picking that ball up off the turf in left field. And then an errant throw in. Madeer could have had second on an error. Instead, stays at first base. It's Sierra Norman now. Game tied 3-3, bottom of the seventh inning. Marion put up two runs in the third to take a 2-0 lead. Could have had more, but settled there. Grace rolled back with two in the top of the fifth and one in the top of the sixth to take the lead. Sierra Norman has a chance now to win the game for Marion with a well-placed ball. She's 1-for-3 on the game. Coach Scott Fleming calling for Norman, making some adjustments, calling out a play or two here. Perhaps a bunt for Norman. Not a candidate to bunt. She will square around, though. Gets it down. And Madeer's in the second base safely. Great bunt by Norman. Not the candidate to bunt there, but she gets the sacrifice down for just the first time this season. And Marion, winning run 120 feet away from scoring. Abby Madeer stands at second. All that's in the way is Grace Meyer and Chloe Huff. Meyer on the day, 1-for-3. Popped up to second base her last time up on a changeup. Flew out to center field earlier today. Meyer hammers this one to left. Brinks camping underneath it. Ball caught. So that will end the seventh. But, hey, new life. Marion, this game's tied up 3-3. We're going to play extras for the first time this season. We'll be back on MU Knights TV. We're playing extra innings on MU Knights TV for the first time this season.
The Lancers, number 9, Jerry Ellis.
as Marion ties the game up against Grace in the bottom of the seventh inning with an RBI single from Abby Madeer. It's now 3-3. Jerry Ellis, the batter for the Lancers, takes ball one. Ellis has had a successful day at the plate. She's 2-for-3 against Olivia Stunkel with a double and a single. Keeping score at home, that'd be a triple and a home run short of the cycle. Good crowd on hand, probably about 90 people or so here watching today's game. We got fans sprayed around the outfield, all around behind the backstop here. Even former Marion softball alum, now medical student, Caitlin Phillips watching. Although she's on the first base dugout, not the appropriate side of the field. Ellis hammers this one foul toward Aaliyah Evans, who's taking photos for us down off the Marion dugout. One, two, the count here. Stunkel looking for a strikeout. Goes rise ball upstairs, misses. Stunkel today, 7 hits allowed, 3 runs, 2 of them earned. She does have 3 strikeouts, but has given up 2 extra base hits, a double and a home run. Here the 2-2 pitch, low and in the dirt for ball 3. Don't want to walk the leadoff here in the 8th. But she will. Second walk today for Stunkel, and Ellis aboard with the walk.
Now batting number 10, Cassie Hayes.
And it'll bring up Cassie Hayes, who last time up hit an RBI single that scored Caitlin Seagrave. That was in the 6th inning. Hayes on the day, 1-for-3. She's grounded out to second, flown out to left. Left-handed batter. Shows bunt, gets it down. Meyer to first, 2-4 on the putout. Sacrifice for Hayes. Does her job though, moves Ellis into scoring position. And it's T.O. O'Connor now up to bat. O'Connor on the game. She's walked and she's 0-for-2, flown out to right and popped out to third. Rather popped up to first. Takes ball in the dirt. Ellis thought about it. Not going, though. Ball misses just a bit outside. Meyer tried to frame it back in. 2-0 the count. Fans wanting that to be a strike. Called a ball. Stunkel misses again. 3-0 the count. O'Connor, candidate to walk here. Count here. O'Connor takes ball 4, and that ball in the dirt moves Ellis to third. So now Grace going to have runners on the corners here.
Now batting number 21, Maddie Ganey.
And Marion going to have a conversation on the mound. Brina Smith coming out to talk to Stunkel. Grace also going to have a pinch runner. Over at first base, Kyra Lewis comes in to run for O'Connor. And so since Marion's in a conversation, Grace in a conversation as well. A lot of action on the field right now. A lot of conversations being had. So fans, we can tell you about Day for the Giving for Marion coming up on Thursday, April 11th. Single-handedly the biggest day of giving for Marion University. All proceeds, any proceeds given to Marion Athletic teams or donated to Marion Athletic teams go directly to those accounts. and can be used for several items. Last season, Marion Softball fundraised very well. Helps pay for their annual, helps fundraise and send their team to Florida every year for spring break. Marion Volleyball was the leader last year in fundraising. Marion Football put up a good show, as did both basketball squads in the fundraising day. Join in for the fun April 11th. You can visit marion.edu/dayforthenights to learn more on that on the day. First pitch hunting is number 21, Maddie Ganey, and she fouls that one away, strike one. Must be out of softballs here, or at least playable softballs, most of them going back foul toward the Grace dugout. That ball camped out over near the tennis courts. We got Eric Perkins on it. Love to see Eric Perkins making a play and helping us out here. Runners on the corner, one away here, top of the eighth. Ganey fouls that one back. We'll start to sense the pressure shift, the atmospheric pressure, that is. Wind's a bit cooler, blowing in out of the west. Blowing straight to right when the flag in left and deep left is straight. Changeup misses low, ball one. Jam shot off the inside, off the knob rather, and that ball fouled back, 1-2. Ball fouled again. We'll do it again at 1-2. Good at bat here for Ganey, staying in it. That pitch misses up, 2-2. Another foul ball sprayed to the tennis court. Two pitch coming from Stunkel. Misses outside. Stunkel over 100 pitches today. One of Stunkel's longest outings of the season. Start to wonder when fatigue could be a factor for number 24, junior from Oakland City, Indiana. Ground ball, Green takes it to first. Norman drops it. Error on the first baseman as she puts that one right on the ground. And just like that, Grace, bases loaded here in the top of the eighth. Good play by Haley Green to look back the runner, make the play at first. Norman just stretched way too early there. It's a good throw from Green, just Norman just straight up dropped it at first base. Well, pressure makes diamonds, and that's what Marion's going to try to do here on this diamond. Bases loaded, top of the eighth inning. Grace, a base hit away from breaking this one wide open. Stunkel fires a changeup into Bree Gardiner for strike one. Gardiner grounded out the second her last time up, but got the scoring started for the Lancers. Part of the reason we're still here in the eighth inning is her solo shot in the fifth inning. One for three on the day. Excuse me, foul ball. Here's the 0-2 from Stunkel. Change up and gets Gardiner the swing. Going to be a play at the plate. Pritchett fires home, up the line, and safe. The throw gets through the tag. It was up the line. Meyer made an effort for it, but the ball pops out of the glove on the slide. Sacrifice fly for Gardiner, scores the go-ahead run as the Lancers now lead 4-3 in the top of the eighth inning.
Now batting number 14, Chloe Huff.
Out retired for Stunkel, though. So now trailing again, 4-3. Chloe Huff swings and misses as that one. It's pitch number 121 comes across the plate from Stunkel. Another changeup, strike two. Stunkel relying on the old two ball here today. Probably see a fastball or rise ball come back here to Huff. Instead, another changeup low, ball fouled. Run it back at 0-2. Changeup again, this ball dropping in shallow left. And two runs will score. That ball dropped right in between Harwager and Hoffman in left field. And just like that, the Lancers have taken a 6-3 lead on Marion. Ball just out of reach of Harwager. Hoffman unable to reach, come in and make the play. Two RBI single for the pitcher. Huff helps her cause. As Montana Brinks now stands in the bat. Chance of pump it up by Endor blaring from the Grace dugout as they now lead 6-3 over the seventh-ranked Knights. Brinks in this game 1-for-3, singled her last time up. Pitch low and in the dirt. For ball three. Pitching change coming here for the Knights here if Brinks will get on base as that ball misses. And that's going to be a change for the Knights. It will be all she wrote for Olivia Stunkel. Get you the pitcher here in just a moment. So it's Abigail McPherson in the pitch for the Knights here. First time we've seen Abigail all season. coming back from thoracic outlet surgery here this year. She fires in strike one. McPherson's thrown strong numbers in her career when healthy. Has struggled with health, though, each of the last 2 years. Quickly ahead in the count, 0-2. Three runs have scored for Grace this inning. They lead 6-3. Ball there.
Ellis has earned the other two runners.
Six runs allowed by Stunkel, four of them earned. These next two runs on base would go to Stunkel, but they are team unearned runs. If they were to score. Comebacker up the middle by Bella Duran. Just going to go station to station, do the Lancers with a base hit. So now base is loaded for McPherson.
Now batting number 11, Hallie Nett.
Good scoop by Sierra Norman at first base as that grounder from hits to Haley Green. Green had all options available. Chooses first base and a great catch. However, there is a conversation. Nope, the out retired. So Marion trailing 6-3. We're going to head to the bottom of the eighth inning. Let's see if the Knights can rally on MU Knights TV. Well, it was do or die last inning for Marion, and it's do or die again here. We're in the bottom of the eighth inning. Marion trailing 6-3 on the scoreboard. And it's going to be up to Abby Hoffman to start a rally for Marion. Grace scoring three runs in the top of the eighth inning to make this a 6-3 game. Marion looking to avoid the falling 1-2 on the season to Grace. Hoffman takes strike one. The Knights and Lancers, the two medieval figures in the Crossroads League, 1-1 on the season. Marion won the first game on March the 12th, lost the second game. Both of those contests were run rules. Hoffman works the count here, 1-1. Huff's 1-1 outside, count now 2-1. This game near 2 hours old. One of the few times you'll see a softball game here at Marion Softball Diamond reach the 2 hour mark. Hoffman under this one, skies in the left field. Brinks has to run in, basket catch, and is able to hold on to it. Falls out of her glove, but she traps it against her quad and makes the catch for out number one.
Now batting for the Knights, number 5, Lily Wynn.
So one out here in the top, or rather bottom of the eighth inning. Chloe Huff looking to lock in the win. as Lily went, though. Might have some other plans. She singles through the left side. Base hit. Marion aboard with a runner here in the top, or gosh, bottom of the eighth inning. Marion going to go for a curtis, or rather a pinch runner at first base. And running for Marion will be Emily Phillips, number 6. Often used pinch runner for Marion. Phillips takes over at first base for Wendt. For Phillips this season, 17th game she's seen. Primarily all as the courtesy or pinch runner. Haley Green goes to right. Irwin makes the catch near the track. Another fly ball out for Marion. As two down here in the bottom of the eighth inning.
Now batting number 9, Anna Pritchett.
Last chance for Marion will be Anna Pritchett. As we get a mound visit for the umpteenth time today. I know in baseball there's a rule that you can only visit the mound 5 times and before you start having to go pitching changes. Grace would have exceeded that today. Good thing this is softball. Speaking of baseball, Marion Baseball tied 4-4 with Mount Vernon in the fourth. A lot of fours there. Jason Cottrell now pitching for the Knights. Came on in relief of Jace Stoops in the third inning. Cottrell got the win Saturday at St. Francis with 3 1/3 innings pitched. Starting off the fourth for Marion, Cottrell has 2 outs retired already in Ohio. Anna Pritchett goes opposite ways, so Marion going to get to the top of their order. After the mound visit, great hit by Anna Pritchett to bring up Savannah Harwager. This game not over quite yet. Tying run at the plate in Harwager, who, as many know, has power in that bat of hers. But the fly ball just not working for Marion today. You would have thought multiple times they had a home run, but just underneath it several occasions. Harwager takes ball one outside. Count now 2-0. Marion looking for a potential walk-off opportunity. 2-0 count here from Chloe Huff. Pitch to the plate. Called a strike on the outer half. Huff going to see her ERA drop a little bit after this game today. Was a 4.22 entering contest. She's seeking her 3rd win of the season. This is her 10th start, 13th appearance. Harwager hammers this one to center field. It will score a run and move Pritchett to 3rd. So just like that, Marion gets a run back. It's 6-4. Not over yet for the Knights.
Now batting number 1, Brooke Knox.
Brooke Knox now batting. Last time we saw her, she hit a sacrifice bunt in the bottom of the 7th inning that moved Harwager into scoring position. Knox here. With 2 outs away, 6-4 the score. Grace leads it, bottom of the 8th inning. Chloe Huff looking for an extra inning complete game win. Harwager takes 2nd base uncontested. Knox represents the game-winning run at the plate. Ahead in the count, 1-0. Knox going to hit this high in the sky to left. Brinks running out of room. Can't make the catch. That ball was up at the track. Brinks, the one time she doesn't make the catch today, is the ball deep into foul left territory. Knox has hit it hard today multiple times. She's flown out to left once. She's doubled in this contest. Does have a sacrifice. Pitch off the plate inside, 2-1. Clouds covering the field now. Knox fouls this one back. 2-2. Marion down to their last strike in this game. Change up, got Knox swinging. Talked by Duran. Duran makes the catch at second base. And the out recorded. Grace, their second upset win of Marion this season. The Knights fall 6-4 in this game. 5:04 now. Game lasted 2 hours and 5 minutes. Marion goes down to Grace 6-4. Read you some final stats here real quick as we wrap this contest up before we switch it over to our next broadcast. Olivia Stunkel, 7 2/3 inning. Eight hits allowed. Six runs, four of them earned. She did walk four and struck out three. Abigail McPherson allowed one hit, but made her first debut of the season, threw five pitches for her in her debut. At the plate, Harwager went 3-for-5. Brooke Knox goes 1-for-4. Abby Madeer, 2-for-4 with 2 RBI. Sierra Norman, Grace Meyer, Abby Hoffman, Lily went all with one hit each. Anna Pritchett with 2 hits. Haley Green, 0-for-3. Marion, 12 hits in the defeat, given up by Chloe Huff, who is the winning pitcher, moving to 3-6 on the season. That'll wrap up game one of our coverage here on MU Knights TV. We'll be back for game two in approximately 25 minutes.